Hey guys, in this video we will build a digital resume using Python. You can find a live demo of this webpage under the following address. Creating this website takes only a couple of minutes, but before we jump into coding out the solution, let us shortly check out the website. In the Hero section, you can download a PDF version of this website by clicking this button. In the resources of this project, I have also included a Word template for you, which you can use to generate your own CV. Below the Hero section, you can insert the links to your social media profiles. After that, we have a blog where you can list your experience and qualifications. And in the same style, I have listed down my hard skills. If I scroll down a bit, we have a work history summary. And at the very bottom, you can include additional links to your projects and accomplishments. Okay, and without further ado, let us create this website from scratch using Python. Before we start, a short disclaimer. The website idea and design are heavily inspired by one of the videos on the Traversy Media channel. In that video, Dennis was building a digital resume website in pure HTML and CSS. While watching the video, I thought creating a similar website in Python might be a cool idea. That said, if you're interested in the HTML and CSS version, I highly recommend the video on Brad's channel. I will, of course, leave the link to that video in the description box. So, thanks a lot to Dennis and Brad for this fantastic project idea. And with that out of the way, let us get started. As a first step, I will install the required dependencies for this project. Therefore, open up your terminal and type pip install streamlit and pillow. We will need streamlit to create the actual website. To insert images into our app, we also need to install pillow. Once we have that out of the way, let us take care of the files and folders we will need throughout the video. First, I will create a new Python file and name it app.py. Additionally, I will create two folders. One it's called assets and the other one styles. Within the styles folder, I will insert a new CSS file. Just create a standard text file and name it main.css. We will come back to that file when we adjust the style of our website. Next, let me switch to the assets folder. Inside this directory, I will paste three files. You can find those files also in my GitHub repo. The link to that repo will be in the description box. In the repo, you can find a PDF and Word version of the CV. Later in the app, we will implement a button to download this PDF file. I just included the Word document if you want to use this CV as a template. Additionally, I have added a profile photo. And here I have also a quick tip for you. If you want to make an awesome profile picture from any photo for free, I recommend the following website. Just upload your image and the website will detect your face and replace the background. You can even further customize the results before downloading the image for free. And with that preparation in place, let us start coding out the website. Therefore, let me open the app.py file. As a first step, I will import the dependencies. To deal with the different file paths, I will import path from pathlib. Next, I will import streamlit as st. And from pill, let me import image. After our imports, I will create a section dealing with the different file paths. The starting point for the navigation will be the current directory of this Python file. You can get the path by using the following line. Here I'm using the parent attribute on the path of this file. If that is not available, for example if you are using Jupyter Notebooks, then I'm using the pathlib method cwd, which stands for current working directory. Once we have to find the current directory, we can construct the other file paths. Our CSS file is located in the styles folder and it's called main.css. Next, we will have the resume in the assets folder. And lastly, I will define the profile picture file path, which is also located within the assets folder. With that in place, let me make some space for the general settings. And I think it might be easier to first type out all variables before explaining them. To change the information on this side easily, I have created this section. Later in the video, we will display those variables in the app. So make sure to change the settings accordingly, like your name, a short description about you, your email address, your social media links, and your projects if you have any. Before we go further, let me highlight a couple of things. You can use an image or emoji for the page icon. If you pick an emoji, you can either insert the emoji name or directly paste the emoji into your script, as I did for the projects. Or if you are feeling lucky, you can also insert random for a random emoji. Regarding the social media and project dictionary, feel free to add or remove links. Later in the video, we will keep things dynamic. So it is okay if you input here less or more links. Also, if you do not have any projects yet that you want to showcase, then feel free to delete that section. Okay, and with our settings in place, let us insert the first Streamlit element, setPageConfig. Here we can specify the page title and icon we have defined in our settings. And to validate that everything is working, let me insert a temporary title. To run the app, I will save the script and go back to my terminal. Ensure that you are in the same directory as your script. In my case, the app.py file is located on my desktop in the digital CV folder. And then type streamlit1 app.py. After pressing enter, Streamlit will open your default browser. To make it easier to see our changes, I will display my text editor and browser next to each other. Alright, and here's our web app with the page title, page icon, and some text. I have set the default theme in my browser to dark mode. That is why I have a black background with white font. If you have a white background with black font, then do not worry. We will change the style of our app anyways later in the video. And speaking of the styling, let us inject the content of our main.css file into our app. To do this, I'm using a little hack by opening the CSS file and inserting the content between an HTML style tag. Ensure to set unsafe allow HTML to true. Currently, our CSS file is empty, but we will take care of that later in the video. To keep things organized, I will also load our other resources here, like our PDF file. To do so, I will read our resume file as binary and save it in a variable called pdfbyte. Next, I will load our profile picture using the pillow module. Simply type image.open followed by the file path. After we have loaded our resources, let me create the hero section. For this, I will make two columns and use a small gap. Within the left column, I will insert our profile picture using st.image. You might want to play around with the width. For my particular photo, the width of 230 pixels worked fine for me. In the second column, I will display the name, a short description of ourselves, and a download button to download the PDF version of our CV. So within the data parameter, I can now pass the PDF byte variable from above. After our download button, I will also provide our email address. Okay, and with that, let me save the file and refresh the website. And here's our header section. When I now click on this button, we can download the PDF version. Okay, this seems to be working. Next, let us take care of our social links, which we have defined in the general settings area. I want to place those links horizontally after our hero section. To add more space between the two sections, I will insert an empty paragraph using the pound sign. To determine how many columns we need, I can count the items in our dictionary using length. Within each column, I want to insert the link to the respective social media platform. For this, I will iterate over our dictionary. So the first link should be in the first column, the second link in the second column, and so on. To get the current index of the iteration, I'm using enumerate. With that, I can now use the write method on the column and insert the platform name and link using an f-string. If I save the file and reload the website, we can see our links. And to test things out, let me click on YouTube. Okay, and this seems to be working. With that in place, let us move on to the next section. As before, I will add some more space using the pound sign. In this part, I want to list down my experience and qualifications using some bullet points. For this, you can use a streamlit-wide element. Just make sure to use a dash at the beginning. In that case, Streamlit will recognize it as an unordered list. Once done, let me save the script again and refresh the website. Okay, and this is what it looks like. For now, I will ignore the styling, but later in the video, we will remove the dots within the list. Below our experience and qualifications, I will list my skills. And this section will be very similar. The only difference is that I have used different emojis for the skills. So when I click on refresh, this is what our page looks like. And with that, let us move on to the next block, our work history. In this section, I want to list my recent jobs. For some visual separation, I will insert a divider by using 3 dashes. Inserting the different jobs will be again very similar to what we have seen so far. In the first row, I will insert the job title and company name, followed by the period and the main task. Also, as before, I use bullet points here. And before going further, let me also check how the work history looks on the website. Okay, great. Here we have our divider, followed by the information about the current work. I will now add 2 more jobs. Let me speed up the video, as I do not want to bore you watching me typing out those sections. So, I have not introduced any new elements. I just adjusted the text for the respective jobs. So, when I refresh the website and scroll down a bit, we can see our full work history. And with that, we are almost done with our website. Optionally, you could also insert links to your projects and accomplishments. For this, I will use another subheader and divider. Next, I will iterate over our project dictionary. For each project, I will insert the project description and the respective link. When I save the file and reload the website, we can see our projects. And to validate that the links are working, let me click on one of the links. In my example, Streamlit will redirect me to a YouTube video. Okay guys, and with that, we are done with our basic website. Let me close my text editor so that we can see the website fully. For the final touch, I want to adjust the site styling. And we will split the styling into 2 parts. In the first part, I will show you some options Streamlit offers regarding the overall appearance. Afterwards, we will use our CSS file to manipulate the styling of some other HTML elements. So, as I said, let us start with the native Streamlit option to style the website. Therefore, create a new folder in the root directory of your app and name it .streamlit. Inside this folder, make a new config.toml file. Open this file with your preferred text editor. Here we can now specify some global settings for our app, like defining the theme. Within the theme section, I will specify the primary, background, secondary, and text colors. Also, feel free to adjust those values to your needs and liking. When I save this file and go back to my website, you will notice that nothing has been changed, even if I reload the page. To apply our custom theme, we need to rerun the app. So, back in my terminal, I will press Ctrl and C to stop the current session before rerunning it. And now we can see that the overall appearance has changed. Yet the customization of the theme is rather limited. For the final touch, I will add some custom CSS. To do so, let me resize my browser and place our main.css file next to it. Do not worry, we are not going to write much CSS here. There will be just a couple of adjustments. As a first step, I will import a font from Google. Once we have imported the font, I will change the font family on the entire website. You should see the new font when I save the file and reload the page. Just a quick reminder, this is working because we have loaded our CSS file into our app using the following code lines. With that said, let me also change the styling of our links. I will remove the underline by setting text decoration to none. The color should be white, and I will set the font weight to 500. Additionally, I want to change the color when I hover over the link. Okay, and with that, let me see how it looks. I think it is looking much better now. Whenever I hover over the links, the color matches our overall theme. The next change will be regarding the bullet points and the divider. For the unordered list, I will set the style type to none. And for the divider, I will override the default values for the top and bottom margin. After saving the file and refreshing the website, we can see that the bullet points disappeared and that the divider moved up slightly. As the last modification, I will remove the Streamlit branding, so the hamburger icon, the colorful header, and the Made with Streamlit footer node. To do that, we can simply set the main menu, footer, and header to hidden. Alright guys, and here it is, our digital CV written in Python. I think that the design is pretty neat and simple. As the last step, you might want to deploy this website to the internet. For this, I already have a separate video on my channel. In that video, I will show you how to deploy your web app to Heroku. You can find the link to that video in the description box and in the info card above. As always, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.